Ngowi TV, informed economies and business perspective.
It is the only industrialization in emerging markets, and now it's on selected economic issues and perspectives in the new industrialization move in Tanzania. Really the basic issues here would be key lessons that Tanzania can learn from emerging markets that have industrialized faster, mostly Asian markets, and I'll focus mainly on China as such. So the broader context of the paper is on the understanding that Tanzania now is it's mainly economic projects really is industrialization, you know. When you look at what the 51st government is saying, is mainly industrialization. And normally, when we are talking about these emerging markets, as Professor Hopper said, really these are countries that have seen rapid industrialization, most of them really moving from agrarian economy to industrial economy, and our focus is Tanzania can learn a lot now from this market. It needs a new industrialization move, and of course you're saying new because it's not the first time that Tanzania is industrializing. I'm skipping some details here. So if you are to unpack the concept of industrialization, basically here we are talking about extensive development of organized economic activity for the purpose of manufacture. Essentially, we are talking about really structural changes from primarily agrarian economy to now, of course, a manufacturing economy. Normally moving from capital labor intensive mode of production to more capital intensive. We are kind of talking more of automation of a production process. If you have to go to history, you know, for example, the first industrial revolution took place in Western Europe and North America in the 18th and 19th century, and we're not interested so much of the history. So I'm skipping some of the issues here. And of course, why focus on industrialization? Tanzania and all the emerging markets that have industrialized have focused so much on moving from agrarian economy to industrial economy because of the obvious benefits of going industrial, including, of course, rapid jobs creation, both incomes, jobs, of course, both direct and indirect, improved the standard of living, foreign earning, you name it. So now what we are seeing is potentials to industrialization is there are a lot of potentials. Now, having potentials is one thing, but then actualizing them is quite another thing. Now, on emerging markets, I would have skipped this slide. This is exactly what Professor Otto has said. And coming from the school that I went, it's obvious that we have a similar definition. That these are nations that are investing, for example, in more productive capacity, moving away from their traditional economies that are relying most on agriculture and export of raw material, and they are rapidly industrializing. And this is typical in most of West Asian countries. And of course, these are the characteristics that Professor Otto has said, I'll skip them. The question of low capital income, rapid growth, less manufactured capital goods, etc. So, when we talk about industrialization in Tanzania, because the purpose is we wanted to learn from the emerging markets, especially Asian ones that have industrialized, and Tanzania now is in a new move. And we have to insist that it is a new move because it's not the first time really that it is attempted to industrialize. If you have to go through Tanzania's historical economic history, you would see really we have from the first development plan way back in 1964. Yes, there was a lot of effort on industrialization. And again, during the Arusha Declaration of 1967, 50 years now, again, we have a lot of issues on industrialization, and the focus mainly on nationalization, having state-owned enterprises, self-reliance, and of course, here the problem was this project lacked the action plan. But also, in the second development plan, way back in 1969, Tanzania again, embarked on the industrialization project, detailed the action plan in place, and then of course the focus was on small scale import substitution industrialization for intermediate goods for agro-processing, and this was mainly labor intensive, and of course there was slow progress for various reasons. Again in 1974, this was the third development plan,
issues of industrialization again featured highly, and this is mainly within agro processing, agricultural material, and import substitution and industrialization. Again, in the mid-1980s, this is the time when we are going to call major and financial reforms in the management of the economy. That's when we went to our private sector. That's when we saw more of market forces of supply and demand. And of course, we have seen privatization. We moved into Vision 2025, sustainable development plan, policies, etc. So, this slide was really to say what we are seeing now with the fifth government in terms of nationalization is not really the first time. It's already a continuation of what has been placed since since early in the 60s. So what we are seeing now with the first government that came to power in 2015 is, if you read the CCM manifesto, you see the way the industry appearing 70 times. And of course, the goals are stated there, you know, issues of increasing industrial sector contribution, issues of employment, etc., encouraging private sector investment, but also issues of protecting industries. And I'm saying this because partly we have seen some of these issues as part of the path that was followed by some of the emerging markets, and we're going to see, for example, China, with issues of protectionism. So, if you read President Magufuli's speech here in the Parliament on the 20th of November 2015, should be 2015, the word industries was mentioned 35 times, and it occupied about 40 pages out of 48 pages. You do computation, is 10.4% of his speech, yeah, was especially on this. And on page 19, he insisted a lot on kind of industries that Tanzania wants to have. Now, the question is, if you are to learn from emerging markets, you know, what should we do in order to achieve, for example, industries that will create mass jobs? Yeah, you could see here there is a little bit of, if we do not interpret it well, we may misunderstand, because with a mass job creating industry, it implies really there have to be labor intensive industries. Yet, if you have to industrialize the way emerging markets industrialize, really they have to be capital intensive. And we understand the capital, it displaces labor. So it's a little bit of contradiction, but then if we understand that the jobs have to be created along the value chain, then this should be correct. But if we think that the jobs will be coming from industries directly, that is wrong. Because in modern day industrial instance, they will have very few people and they will be highly automated. So it's very good to be able to interpret these things. And of course, the other aim is to have industries for mass domestic consumption and exporting excess. As part of the debate that comes in here is the question of test and preference, or which seems to be inclined more towards imports than domestically produced goods. So producers really have to up their standard. But also the Tanzania government now wants industries that will use a lot of domestic raw material, which now, in my view, according to Tanzania, agriculture-based economy to more industrialized through mainly agro-processing. In the 5 years of the plan, started 2016-17, will go up to 2022, you see the focus again is on industrialization. You could see the word naturally industrialization for economic development, for economic transformation, and human development is the main theme. So there is no doubt that the focus of Tanzania is, yes, of having industrial economy. Now, the key issue you're saying, what lessons can Tanzania pick from the emerging markets? And here, because of time, I will just pick some few cases, some few lessons from China. You could see, when you're looking at the emerging markets, typical emerging markets, I would say China seems to be one of the typical, China, India, and the like. You could see what made China what it is now, the factor of the world, or the worship of the world, is really the role of the state. The role of state. Chinese government has been behind the industrialization process. And of course, behind the whole economic transformation and development, mainly through, among other things, making sure that there is a conducive, friendly, attractive business and investment climate, ensuring the availability of high quality and quantity of infrastructure, both what you call orthodox and unorthodox, both the soft and hard infrastructure. Issues of policy, legal, and regulatory framework that are friendly to industrial development. Issues of skills and talent among the labor force. No, issues of fiscal policy, predictable fiscal policy, all those stuff have been partly enabled by the state. So Tanzania can keep that lead from China in its industrialization project. And of course, the question of having typical industrial policy, if you read the author that I've said here, you could see among other things in the industrial policy was the question of protectionism. And Nyerere said this several times that really you can't put giants with those who are not giants. Industries need to be protected for a while until they can really compete. So the issues of the famous phrase of infant industries protectionism, through tariffs and underneath protectionism. This is again, China did this, most of the emerging economies did this. It's also time to do it in Tanzania. But the question is, how long do you protect? You have to protect only those who can survive. You have to protect those who can be efficient. You cannot protect those which are not really kind of struggling to outcompete others. But also, China had a lot of what we call a selective intervention in business activities with a view of promoting the development of targeted industries and projects. So, whereas it left the private sector to do the industrialization process, the government had to intervene. What we call, where there is a market failure, the long arm of the state had to intervene to correct market failures for industries where the private sector won't be having enough appetite to invest in, then the state had to intervene. So for Tanzanian case, we may have this selective intervention, but of course, I would argue that it's very important to avoid, in my view, over intervention. There are times where the business of the state is not the business of the business, but it's the business really of creating conducive environment for the private sector now to lead the economy. I would also argue, for example, if you are to learn from China, the issues of having special economic zones, industrial parks, export processing zones, you have quite a number of them in Tanzania, and there is argument of having more of them. But really, if you are to read from a new book that has just came out with Mufuruki and others, it was just launched last week, and I have a copy here, you could see what China did really when it comes to establishing industrial parks, special economic zones. It went step by step. Started one, learned for over years, corrected all the mistakes. When it had perfected the model, it rolled out throughout China. Now, I think if you are not learning these lessons, we may enter into a trap of calling special economic zones and having them everywhere, and there won't be anything special then. So really, it's very important to start with one and learn from all the mistakes, having the perfect model of a special economic zones, and then you roll out elsewhere. Because with a special economic zone, the purpose is to have all that it takes for industrial firms to be attracted. You de-risk investment in these areas. You kind of cultivate appetite for investors in terms of providing all of the infrastructure. You know, we are saying a typical special economic zone, you hook the facilities, if it's water, if it's electricity, very easily. You make sure that all the infrastructure are in place. And of course, there is huge fiscal incentive. Normally, in a typical special economic zone, you would be given tax incentive if you export 80%. For example, if it's an export process zone, if you export 80% of what you're producing, then you get a lot of tax incentive. But then we need really a lot of lessons. Going rather fast, you could see, if you have to learn from China, again, it moved from labor-intensive to capital-intensive industrialization, which now, if you are to go industrial, I think this is the way to go. And of course, state ownership and control of economic activities was so much a prevailing Chinese economy. And I would say, maybe Tanzania should avoid this, because again, it is really not in consonant with exactly what you're saying, what the state of the economy now. Yeah, time is up almost. There are issues of decentralization, issues of market liberalization, etc. Now I'm coming almost to the end. We understand it's not the first time that Tanzania is attempting to industrialize. It attempted industrializing since 1960s. But then other emerging markets, and I'm not sure whether Dr. Komba would allow me to say Tanzania is also an emerging market, but other emerging markets than Tanzania, like Asian countries, China, India, etc., have industrialized, and we have a lot of lessons to pick from China in order to avoid really reinventing the wheel. So we need systematic learning from industrialized and industrializing emerging markets such as China if you are to perfect our industrialization project. Thank you.